Thank you. Look up.
Okay.
Check, check, check. Testing 1, 2, 3. Hunter mic check 1, 2, 3. We are closing in on totality here in Marble Falls. A little breezy, but the cloud cover. Check, check, check. Test, test. 1, 2, 3. Hunter mic check 1, 2, 3. Does that sound right? Does that look weird?
No.
Looks fine.
I'm just trying to protect it from the.
Yeah, can you hear me? Is that going to be, do we need to make shorter? Check 1, 2, I am talking. Check 1, 2, 3. Do you need to make the tripod shorter? Okay. What's the moment that we've all been waiting for with people gathered around here?
This is good though, I like it.
Okay, perfect.
Everybody behind you.
Mic check, 1, 2, 3, mic check, mic check.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Marble Falls, Texas. We are now less than 10 minutes away from Totality. We are standing here in the Meadow Lakes neighborhood. We are on the north shore of Lake Marble Falls, and where we're standing, Totality is at 134, and there will be 4 minutes and 13 seconds of Totality. Now, this is incredibly exciting, and I'll tell you what, about a minute ago, I was feeling really lucky with the weather that we are experiencing. We've had some high thin clouds. Now we do have some of these low clouds which are coming in. So this might be a little bit of a game time decision determining what is the extent of this that we can see. But either way, even if it's cloudy, the path of totality, we're still in it. It's going to get dark, and it is still going to be a really, really cool experience. Now, as we wait on totality, let's get into the basics of what we can expect coming up with the total solar eclipse. So here is how things work. A total solar eclipse, right? We have the moon, which is passing between the Earth and the sun. What that means is that the moon will be casting a shadow on the Earth, and it is this shadow, we call the direct shadow, the umbra, that will be passing directly over us here where I am standing in Marble Falls and across a good chunk of central Texas. So you get under the shadow and it gets darker even in the middle of the afternoon. Now, you may remember back in the fall, we had an annular solar eclipse, which in Austin, we did not have annularity. We had a partial, it was about 89%. This is going to be different. The full thing this time, 100% of the sun covered up by the moon. So those are the basics. I want to show you the path of totality here. This is it. It's about a 115-mile wide path, which goes from about, in our area, Austin, west into the hill country. Again, this is the direct shadow of the moon, which will be racing across the Earth's surface. It moves very quickly, over 1,000 miles per hour. The path, we've known about this for years. It's funny, I was presenting at a school, I was in Hutto, talking about this the other day, and I realized I've been talking about this solar eclipse for 4 years. I've been showing the same graphic to kids at elementary schools, and now the day is finally here. So that is the path of totality. I want to show you the time in totality, and this is what is just so great about what we are about to witness. In Austin, 1 minute, 44 seconds of totality. Where I am standing, again, there is going to be 4 minutes and 13 seconds of totality. For places like Fredericksburg, it is over 4 minutes and 20 seconds. So this is just going to be a truly unique, once-in-a-lifetime experience. All right, with that being said, enough of the fanfare. Let's get the party started here. We have crews who have been all across central Texas today and taking part in our stream today. We have Isabella Vasco, who is live in Dripping Springs. We also have a reporter right now at the Dell Diamond in Round Rock. So let's start with Isabella. That is Jessica Cha, who is in Round Rock. Let's start with Isabella, who is live in Dripping Springs. Isabella, I know we've been kind of dodging cloud cover. Give me the latest on the conditions that you're seeing, and what's the overall vibe where you are?
Well, Hunter, you talk about the significance and the uniqueness of this moment. Well, right here on Mercer Street in Dripping Springs, we've been participating in the block party since 10 in the morning. Everyone's kind of been doing their own thing, but I think that you can point to some moments in time where you share an experience and you remember where you were. I was talking to families about why they wanted to share this moment together. They said that there's very few moments in time in their lives where they can point to where they were and what they were doing. And I think marking this moment in time, we can all remember here in Dripping Springs. As you can see, everyone here is looking out here with their glasses, just trying to bond over this shared experience here together. We've been talking to people from I'm hearing people are saying they're tingling, they're excited, they're booing, they're awing. You know, they're really just, and they've traveled from all over the world. We've heard as far as the United Kingdom, people in Colorado, people in California, people from everywhere that are really excited to see this moment. And so I think that's what's unique about it, is that we're just really bonding over the shared experience, coming off of the pandemic, coming off of sometimes when you can see in the world that there's a lot of hard moments. I think this bonding over this just shows the humanity all inside of us. So we're really excited. How are you guys feeling? How are you guys feeling? We have some selfie taking, we have some applause, we have some ooing, we have some awing. We're really excited. And I feel the anticipation really building here in the air. And I can already feel it dark. I can feel it dark. Okay, we're gonna stick around, get some more reaction, talk to some more people, and we cannot wait to share more with you tonight. But for now, I'll bring it back to you. Live in Dripping Springs, Isabella Basco for KVUE News.
Isabella, thank you very much. You talk about feeling how dark it's becoming. We are feeling that right here in Marble Falls as well. Before we check in here in Marble Falls, let's go to Round Rock. Jessica Cha is at the Dell Diamond right now. So let's check in. Jessica, what are the viewing conditions? Are we getting a decent view of this thing? And then tell us, how's the mood? Is everybody excited there in Round Rock?
Yes. Yes, Hunter. I am ready, and so is everyone at Dell Diamond Stadium. Now, it is slowly getting darker and darker. It's so interesting. There have been breaking the clouds recently, and every time the sun comes out, people go absolutely wild. They are cheering for the eclipse. Now, speaking of people, earlier we were talking to organizers and they were saying that they sold out about 750 tickets, but I was talking to people at the ticket booth earlier and they were saying they probably surpassed over 1,000 tickets, handing out boxes and boxes full of these eclipse glasses. So people are very excited to be here. I was talking to team president of Dell Diamond, Chris Almendarez, and he was saying that he thought this would be a great venue for people to come and watch the eclipse. There are 6,000 seats, so there are absolutely enough space for everybody. And he was saying that they have music, they have a person to explain the science of all the eclipse, and they have face painting and everything else. I think this is a great place for people to come out. We did ask him if he was concerned about the cloudy weather, and he said that they're kind of used to it. You know, they kind of get through all of that weather, and it's looking good right now. Everyone is super excited. It's just minutes away, live in Round Rock. Jessica Cha, KVUE News.
Jessica, thank you very much. Again, we're really starting to get dark here in Marble Falls. Unfortunately, I'm looking up. Hey, we got a little peek of it, but just at kind of the worst possible time, we've had some low clouds come in. Now, still, it's going to be cool. Now, I believe we have another shot we want to show you guys. Our sister station in San Antonio also covering this event. We have some other places in our area like Fredericksburg who will be seeing totality a little bit prior to us here in Marble Falls. Okay, so it is 1:31 right now. Fredericksburg, speaking of, at 1:32 is going to experience totality, and that's going to be one of those spots that has well over 4 minutes of totality. Now, in addition to it obviously getting darker, you can feel the temperature drop here. I was looking at one of the LCRA Hydromet sensors here in Marble Falls, and it went up to 81 degrees about an hour ago, and then the temperature started to drop. So obviously start limiting the incoming solar radiation, and temperatures get a lot cooler. So it is getting dark, and we are almost here to game time, 1:31. Unfortunately, cloud cover here at just the worst possible time has rolled in, and it is now kind of obscuring things. But 1:31, we are 3 minutes away from totality here in Marble Falls. Now, what's interesting about how quickly it gets dark is it's not like a linear relationship, right? Over the past 1 minute, so in the 1 minute before totality, you go from 100 times darker than normal to 1,000 times darker than normal. That is how powerful the sun is, and that's why we tell people there's a big difference between being at 99% totality and being at 100% totality. That last 0.1% of the sun still gives you like 1,000 times brightness. So, coming up on 1:32, I apologize, I keep looking at my watch, just want to make sure we don't miss this here as we go into totality. Now, with the cloud cover around, unfortunately, I think we're not going to get a good view of some of the things that would indicate the beginning of totality. So if we didn't have cloud cover around, what we'd be looking for is Bailey's beads. That is the last little bit of sunlight going through the mountains and the valleys on the surface of the moon. I'll be honest, that was one of the things that I was really excited to see, and that's not something that we're going to have a glimpse of, it looks like here, just because of the cloud cover. Although, okay, 1:32, here's a quick little break in the cloud cover. Coming up, I'm going to look up and see if we get a little bit of a view of things. We have Heikki Mustonen, who is here filming things on the ground, and we have Dennis, who has the filtered view, who is trying to look up at the sun to get the trying to get a view of the eclipse, but unfortunately with the low clouds. All right, here we are. We're going to get a quick little break here. Okay, and it's 1:33. This might work out perfectly. I've got a quick little break in the cloud cover so I can see that last little sliver. Again, what we're going to look for here, if we're lucky, we might see this where you get Bailey's beads, that last little bit of light coming through, the last little minute where you get that last little bit of light, and there we go. The cloud cover just covered it up from my perspective. We are 1 minute away. Wait and see if we get another little opening. And again, the way that Bailey's beads works is you get a couple beads of light, and then eventually there's one or two, and you get that diamond ring effect. But with the sun covered up right now, we're just not getting a good view of things. Folks cheering here. All right, there it is, 134. So we are officially in totality here in Marble Falls. Again, that will last for 4 minutes and 13 seconds. And you can see how much darker it got. Hakey Mustin, our photographer, he turned on the lights here. I mean, it's almost like nighttime out here. One of the things, obviously we don't want the cloud cover. We're not getting the view of the solar corona right now, which otherwise we would be able to see. Unfortunately, that's that outer atmosphere of the sun, another one of the things that I was really excited to see. But with the cloud cover, it's actually a little bit darker than it would otherwise be. You don't have any ambient light coming in from outside of totality. So it is very dark. It is noticeably cooler. And I'll tell you what, even though it is cloudy, this is still just really, really cool to witness. We have a lot of folks who are here. Again, we're on the shore of Lake Marble Falls. We have a lot of folks here who are witnessing totality with us. It's breezy, it's cool, and it feels like it's evening, but it is not. It is 1:35 in the afternoon, and we are currently experiencing a total solar eclipse. I'm hoping that there are some spots that are a little bit luckier. Now, if you are watching in Austin, I understand we have people all across the area. Austin coming up at 1:36, that is when totality will begin in Austin. For Austin, it's going to last for 1 minute and 44 seconds. Now, it may seem quick, but what's remarkable is how fast the shadow of the moon moves across the surface of the Earth, again, over 1,000 miles per hour for North America. And before I finish that thought, our crew at the studio in Austin, they're heading out to experience the solar eclipse. So you guys enjoy it. It's really cool how we got that a couple of minutes ahead here in Marble Falls. So totality began at 1:34. It's now 1:35. We've got another 3 minutes or so of totality. But again, getting back to that thought of how fast this happens, the shadow of the moon moving over 1,000 miles per hour across the surface of the Earth here, how fast did it? How long does it take to go across all of North America? Only about 1 hour and 35 minutes. That's for totality, not the partial, but for totality. 1 hour and 35 minutes. Came on shore around Sinaloa, Mexico, races across North America, and then we'll exit later on this afternoon near Newfoundland, Canada. And I'm hoping if we're lucky, maybe we could just get a quick little glimpse here, 1:36. So we've got another 2 minutes or so of totality. And by the way, it works the same way on the opposite side of totality, where you can once again see the diamond ring effect in Bailey's beads. So maybe if we're lucky, we get a little break here. We were so close, guys. I promise y'all, like 7 minutes before, right before we started this, we had just these high thin clouds. I posted about it on my social media. I thought we were going to get lucky, but unfortunately the low cloud cover moved in. But still, this is just a really special thing to witness. Here's another little break coming up. We might get a view here. 1:37, so we're still in totality. I'm gonna be quiet here for a second and see if we get a little view of things. Oh, and there it is. I've got a view. Look at that. Wow. Oh my goodness. That is it. The clouds have parted at the perfect time, and you can see the solar corona. That shot right there, that 10 seconds made it all worth it right there. How special is that? The thin, wispy spiderweb looking outside of the moon. That is the solar corona. You can only ever see that with the naked human eye during a total solar eclipse. And that is what we just witnessed here in Marble Falls. And with that, the cloud cover moves back over. But wow. It is 1:38, so we are coming up here in a matter of seconds on the end of totality. I cannot believe that we just had a little break in the cloud cover. It was perfect where we were able to see it. You can hear, we've got folks who are on boats out on the water. More folks who are here on shore, again at Lake Marble Falls, who also witnessed that. It was only, 9 or 10 seconds, but just that little snippet made things worth it to be able to see totality. And just like that, totality has ended now. So look how quickly it starts to get brighter. Again, that is how powerful the sun is. The last minute before totality, it goes from 100 times darker than normal to 1,000 times darker than normal. And then it's the opposite. You go from 1,000 times darker than normal back to just 100 times darker than normal. And now things are rapidly becoming brighter here in Marble Falls. Well, guys, we didn't get to witness the corona for four straight minutes, but I will tell you, just being able to see that for 10, 15 seconds, that was worth it. You know, that's what we came out here to Marble Falls for, and I'm glad that we went to a place that had a little bit longer of totality. That made the difference. Again, in Austin, so it is 1:39. Totality has now ended in Austin. In Austin, there was 1 minute 44 seconds. If we only had 1 minute and 44 seconds, we would not have been able to see that here in Marble Falls, but we got a tiny little glimpse of it. I'm not able to see the stream that you guys are seeing, but I hope that Dennis was able to get a shot. Yeah, Dennis is giving me the thumbs up, so we got a little bit of that picture right there. Our photographer, Heike, is wow, that's pretty remarkable. Yesterday, we were doing this forecast. We've been focusing on this cloud cover forecast and hoping that we would have some breaks, and just at the right perfect time. Here's another little break, so I guess I need to put the glasses back on. We're outside of totality, but we're getting some breaks now where we're starting to see it again. Again, the partial began at 12:17. And totality is now finished, so now we'll go back partial the other way, and things will come to an end later on this afternoon. 1:40 now, so totality has ended in Austin. Next up, it's going to be parts of North Texas and the Dallas area who will be experiencing this as this swings across the United States. So with that being said, I think that is going to do it for us here in Marble Falls. We appreciate everybody who is watching on the stream with us. If you are here in Central Texas, I hope you were watching on your phone and you were able to get a quick glimpse of it like we did. It was not a solid 4 minutes and 13 seconds of witnessing it like what we were hoping, but we got just a little glimpse there at the perfect time. And it allowed us to view the solar corona. I didn't get to see Bailey's beads on the beginning, but we saw the solar corona. And in my mind, that makes it worth it. So with that being said, we will leave you with that. Again, thank you to everybody who tuned in. We appreciate you watching here with us and witnessing this once-in-a-lifetime moment. And we will leave you with that. Y'all enjoy the rest of the day, and I hope you got a good view of the eclipse.